Parshas Zohar. Zohar, Eisa Asher Oseh Lecha Amalek. Because the real force behind causing Jews to commit sins of Pigam HaBris, which is the main cause for all lost articles, lost holiness, lost souls, is the Tumah of Amalek. Amalek represents the power of Tumah that causes Jews to sin. V'alkein hu roidev tamid achar machne don. And this is why the Torah tells us that Amalek especially went after Shevet Don, the tribe of Don, which was the tribe when the Jews traveled in the desert. Don was the Shevet that traveled in the back. We know the Mishkan was in the center, and the different Shvatim were divided into four groups, and the group of three in the back were headed by Shevet Don. They are called Me'asef Lechol HaMachnois, the Kedusha. They're the ones who gathered in all the straggers, all the lost souls. Or if anyone lost anything while they were traveling, Don were the ones in the back who would pick up all the lost articles and lost souls again. This Ma'asef Lechol HaMachnois, the Kedusha of Holiness. Shemechapes Umoitze Kol HaVedos, Kama Shapirosh Rashi Sham. Shevet Don were the ones who searched for and found and gathered in all the lost ones. Va'amolek Mizgare Bohem Beyoser. And this is why Amalek specifically went after Shevet Don, because Amalek represents that power of Tumah that's always lying in ambush and trying to attack those lost souls, because that's what gives Amalek their power, their energy. Iker Hizgarusoi al Oison Shehoya Ha'onon Poltam. And this is why the Torah tells us that the main attack of Amalek, what Amalek was really after, were those who were rejected by the clouds. We know that there were these seven holy clouds that accompanied the Jews while they were traveling in the desert. And the Torah tells us that certain Jews who committed certain types of sins were not included, were not under the cover and protection of these clouds. So those whom the clouds spit out, rejected, those were the ones who Amalek went after. Bechinas, as it says, Vayezanev Becho Kol HaNecheshalim Acharecho. This refers to the lost ones, those that were rejected. The word HaNecheshalim is comprised of two words. It has the word Nachosh in the center, the Nun Ches Shin, and the remaining letters spell the word Mila. And Mila, the mitzvah of Mila, Mem Yud Lamed Hey, is the ultimate in Tikkun HaBris. Every Jew who has a Bris Mila is already included in the concept of Tikkun HaBris. Usually, the term Tikkun HaBris applies specifically to purity in the relationship between men and women.
Does it apply only to men or not to women as well?
To women as well, in terms of a woman getting married, a woman having shalom bayis, a woman bringing children into the world, and a woman conducting herself with tznius. All the laws that pertain to a man and a woman's very significant role in this shlemus. Again, a man's tikkun habris is not complete without the wife. V'alkein tzrichin lizkor heitev maisei Amalek. This is why we have to really remember well the whole story of Amalek. Kama shekosuv lois ishkach. As the Torah says, zocher lois ishkach. Don't forget this. Ki tzrichin lizkor heitev kol ma she'ibed al yedei ta'avoysov. Because a Jew has to remember very well all of the things that I lost as a result of my desires. V'ho'ikr hu hazikorim. And the main thing here is the memory, to remember.